my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making bindi curry. Bindi curry is basically okra soup. So this okra soup is basically yogurt based soup and tastes so delicious and very healthy. You can serve with the Indian bread, Indian flat breads, or you can just drink as it is, however you like. Most of the time we prepare the gluten free bread known as Jowar or Bajra roti. Goes very well with this kind of soup. Now most of the time I use fresh vegetables, but today I'm just going to use the frozen okra. Earlier I showed two recipes of okra bindi and I had so many questions whether they can use the frozen okra, and let's see how the result comes out today when you use the frozen okra. So let's start making bindi curry. The first thing I'm going to do is stir fry the okra. I need a stir-fried completely cooked okra, so cooked bindi. And here I have taken the white non-stick pan. Make sure to take the white non-stick pan, and into this pan I'm going to take enough oil to cook okra. Now I want my okra crispy, so I add a little bit more oil, but if you wish you can just add just a little bit of oil and cook the okra. And here I have this frozen okra pack, so cut this pack, and they are pre-cut okra bindi, so ready to add into this pan. And I'm going to add all the okra, and I'm going to season this okra with salt only. Salt to taste, no other spices needed at this point. And I have the stove turned on medium heat. So I'm going to cook this okra on a medium heat. Keep stirring bindi occasionally till it gets done completely. And you can cook till the consistency that you like. I kind of like my okra crunchy, as I said earlier. So I want to cook till it's completely done. While the okra is cooking, I'm going to prepare the yogurt. So into this pot, I'm going to prepare the yogurt. And here I have this beaten mix of yogurt and sour cream. Now you can use only yogurt if you wish, but I have the mix of yogurt and sour cream. I every day make the curry, Gujarati curry, so I always keep this ready, beaten yogurt and sour cream. The most part is yogurt. Sour cream is just for 1 cup of yogurt. I add about 1 tablespoon of sour cream, that's all. So this is the mix already and beaten already. So I'm ready to use this. And here I have this besan, chickpea flour. This is must ingredient for this soup because we're going to heat up this soup. When you heat up the soup, we need some kind of a binding so that the yogurt doesn't get separates out or curdle out. Into this pot, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make the thick paste of this besan chickpea flour with water. So here I have about 2 tablespoons of besan chickpea flour, and add just a little bit of water. If you add more water, then you won't be able to make the paste. It will be all lumpy, which we don't want. We want a smooth paste of this chickpea flour. Add little water at a time. You can make the paste and you can break the lumps easily if you have just a little water. Alright, so this paste is ready. Now this yogurt and sour cream, there's no water added. It's beaten without water. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take about 2 cups of this mix. So basically I'm making here curry, Gujarati curry. So you can watch the detailed video of Gujarati curry. So I'm just going to eyeball here about 2 cups of beaten yogurt with the sour cream. And now into this mixture, I'm going to add spices, masala paste, and water. Make sure that you take the cold water. Salt to taste, cumin powder, just pinch of turmeric powder, From my 3G box, I'm going to add green chili, garlic, and ginger. Green chili to taste, ginger, garlic. Mix all these ingredients first. Now I'm going to add water. Add water according to your preference. Consistency of this soup or bhindi curry is really up to you, whether you want it thick or thin. And make sure that we're going to also add stir-fried okra, so which is gonna make a little bit more thick. So you can choose your own thickness, but I kind of make almost like a curry the way I prepared my everyday curry, the Gujarati curry. So you can see that it is just like a running water, the running thick kind of water. And that's a perfect consistency. Now I'm going to prepare tarka. And to prepare my tarka, here I have the fresh curry leaves, mito limro. Here I have some red chilies, the whole red chilies. And I'm also going to add some mustard seeds, cumin seeds, fenugreek seeds. So here I have the oil heating up. And to this I'm going to add a few red chilies, the whole dry red chilies. Optional, if you have, you can use, otherwise leave it out. You can flip these chilies with the spoon. And now I'm ready to add other seeds. Here I have mustard seeds, fenugreek seeds, methi. And here I have the cumin seeds. Turn off the stove. And here I have the curry leaves, mito limro. What I normally do, when I add this, I always cover so that it doesn't get all over. Because when you add curry leaves, it tends to get all over. So you can just cover it right away so that you don't make any mess around your on your stove. So this is done. Oh yes, don't forget to check on your okra. Bhindi. Okra is cooking good. Let's check on our okra again, bhindi. That it has slightly changed the color now. Some of the okra has got little brown even. Give it a stir again. Let it cook. Okra, bhindi is completely cooked, and now let me show you how they look like. So you can see that it has changed the color now. Some part of it look a little green, some part looks a brown, kind of black. So that's how I cook my okra, but you can cook however you like. The consistency, if you like crunchy or if you like soft. So you can see that this is how I have cooked this okra, bhindi. So here I have cooked okra ready. Here is our soup, kind of a curry. Yogurt, mixture of yogurt, water, and a little bit of sour cream. So that's ready. And here is my tarka seasoning. So now it's time to put together everything and bring it to boil. So into this yogurt mixture, add this okra. Add this seasoning. And now I'm going to boil it. Bring it to boil. Keep stirring continuously. So basically this bhindi curry is ready. You can see that the steam coming out of it, and it's done. I'm going to take out into this serving bowl here. And on the top, sprinkle some finely chopped fresh cilantro, dhania, coriander leaves. I'm going to sprinkle some dhania on the top, coriander leaves. And look at this bhindi curry. So this bhindi curry is ready. You can serve with rice, rotis, or just drink itself. So this was all about bhindi curry, okra soup. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.